Station master Virendra Kumar and his colleagues control about 150 trains that pass through this village every day.
No train can come to this station without my permission.
It's a manual system. These knobs and levers virtually unchanged for half a century. The station serves a total population of 30,000 people. It's this kind of connectivity to small towns and villages across the country that makes the Indian Railways what it's now often called, a lifeline.
Without the train, life would be very difficult. The average Indian would not be able to go anywhere.
Some 25 million passengers travel across the vast 65,000 kilometer network every day. But it's still far from being a 21st century train system.
So I've got a ticket to go from Delhi to Ludhiana, and I've got number 64 on the waiting list. And the only way of really finding out if you've actually got a seat is to come here on the morning of the train and see if your name is there.
It's not the most convenient of systems. Inside the train, passengers squeeze into every inch of space they can find, some even sitting on the overhead baggage racks, storing their belongings elsewhere, while others seek to make a quick buck by entertaining tired travelers.
This trip would cost me $200 by plane, but by train, it's only costing me $6.
Just $6 for a distance of 2,000 kilometers. These below-cost tariffs, though, is one of the reasons the Indian Railways recorded losses of $4.5 billion in 2012. It's long been subsidized by the government, but for the first time ever, they plan to link passenger fares and freight rates with fuel prices. The hope is to generate earnings to modernize facilities.
Today, if you have a track, you send one train and you wait for a while till you send another train because the signaling is manual. So as soon as you provide electronic signaling, capacity goes up. But when capacity goes up and speed goes up, you got to really also modernize track because a lot of our track is old, obsolete, need to be fixed.
The government is set to invest more than $250 billion to overhaul existing infrastructure. Dedicated freight corridors are also in the works.
70% of revenues come from freight. We really need to move a lot more goods on train than we have been moving in the past. I believe if we invest $200 billion to modernize Indian railways, perhaps Indian GDP will go up by 1.5% to 2%.
Getting the Indian Railways back on track is not going to be easy, but it may just be the lifeline India needs to jumpstart the economy. Sunima Udas, CNN, New Delhi.